Hello everyone, welcome to Pharmaceutical Concepts, and here I come with the next method of multi-component analysis by UV spectrometry. This is the seventh method of multi-component analysis by UV spectrometry we are learning. Earlier we have seen six different methods of multi-component analysis. The name of this method is derivative spectroscopy. Now, this method is again a method of multi-component analysis by UV spectrometry. Now, what is multi-component analysis? Multi-component analysis means analysis of that particular formulation which has more than one drug. For example, if I have formulation having two drugs X and Y into it. Now, both these drugs, they give absorbance at each other's lambda max. So, while analyzing each drug from this formulation, we cannot use or we cannot measure their absorbance at their lambda max, because at the lambda max of X, Y is also giving absorbance, and at the lambda max of Y, maybe X is also giving the absorbance. And therefore, we learn in multi-component analysis how to analyze such formulations having two drugs giving absorbance at each other's lambda max. Now, how it is done in derivative spectroscopy, that we will be learning. Again, one of the very popular advantage of derivative spectroscopy is background correction. It is very commonly used method for background correction. Mathematical derivative of the absorbance with respect to wavelength of radiation is calculated by the instrument itself, electronically or by using microcomputer. The method was first developed in 1953. The first analog spectroscopy was built by Singleton and Kohler. The method then developed in high speed when new generation of spectroscopy controlled by computers were constructed. This method, that is derivative spectroscopy, increases selectivity of the method by derivatizing the digital data. Also, it increases selectivity of the method by removing spectral interferences. Derivative spectroscopy involves conversion of zero order spectrum to first order, second order, and higher derivatives. Now, what is this zero order spectrum or zero ordered spectrum by derivative spectroscopy? Now, the zero order spectrum is nothing but the fundamental spectrum. We call it as fundamental spectrum, which is nothing but absorbance versus wavelength, the normal spectrum which we get after scanning any drug solution, that is called as zero order spectrum. Now, for getting this particular spectrum, the solution which we prepare and we fill that solution in the cuvette, and this cuvette is then kept in the instrument, then all the UV radiations are passed through this solution and we get this spectrum. Okay, now we don't have to do any further dilutions or we don't have to make any changes in the solution. Okay, whatever spectrum we have got, that spectrum on the computer itself, on the software itself, we will have the direct option of converting this spectrum into the higher derivative, for example the first order. So, this is done by instrument itself. Okay, we just have to click on the software that convert this fundamental spectrum into first order. So, it will just convert it into the first order spectrum, and then it will just convert it into the second order spectra and higher derivative. Higher derivative means third order, fourth order, that is also possible. However, as the differentiation order increases, the noise also increases. And if a lower derivative is fine, going to higher derivative is
waste of time and effort. Now let us know more about fundamental spectrum, that is the zeroth order or D0 spectrum. It is also called as D0 spectrum. See, the spectrum, that is absorbance versus wavelength, where we see this lambda 3 as the lambda max of this particular spectrum. This wavelength, this point is the lambda max of this particular spectrum. So absorbance on y-axis, lambda max. Now, this fundamental or zero order spectrum is then converted by the instrument to first derivative, or which we also called as D1 spectrum. Now you can see, in derivatized spectra, maxima and minima. See, this part we call it as maxima, this part we call it as minima. Of the original function, take zero values, and inflections are converted into maxima or minima. This is about first order spectra. See, this wavelength, this is the same range, okay, same range of the UV radiation, same range. Now, earlier at this lambda 3, we have got the maximum absorbance for this particular drug. So, we call it as lambda max for this particular drug. But when the same spectrum is converted into its first order, what happens? At this maximum absorbance, now the absorbance is zero. Okay, and now these are the inflections. At this point, we got one maxima and one minima. So you can note this change. This is the derivative, first derivative of the absorbance. So rate of change of absorbance with wavelength is plotted on y-axis. This is the plot of rate of change of absorbance with wavelength against wavelength, or we can also call it as plot of the slope of the fundamental spectrum against wavelength, and in simple words, plot of dA by d lambda against lambda. The derivative spectra are more structured than the original spectra. Since the number of peaks goes on increasing with the increase in the order of derivative. In the first order derivative spectrum, the original band splits into two. In the second order derivative spectrum, the original band splits into three. Thus, the number of peaks in a spectrum of order n would be n plus 1. So, if it is third order derivative spectrum, then the total number of peaks seen in the spectrum would be, in the derivatized spectrum would be 4. Now this is the maxima, this is the minima of the first order derivative spectrum. So this wavelength is the point of maximum absorbance on positive side and maximum absorbance on minimum side. So, we should say minimum absorbance on this side. So, this lambda 3, which was lambda max, which was called as lambda max in D0 spectrum. Okay. Now, same wavelength is now called as crossover point in D1 spectrum, that is in first derivative spectrum. See, this is a very important point. This wavelength lambda 3, this wavelength, we called it as lambda max for that particular drug when in fundamental spectrum, right? In zero order spectrum. But now at the same wavelength, when this particular spectrum is converted by the software into the first order derivative, what happened? At this wavelength, there is zero absorbance. So, we call it as crossover point now. when it is in first order spectrum. Now here, let us see the further conversion of this particular spectrum. Now if you see this y-axis, what is plotted? The higher derivative. It is further derivatized. Okay. Now let us see what are the changes. Okay. So this is zero order, first order and second order. This second order spectrum is a plot of curvature of the D0 spectrum against wavelength. Also plot of D square A by D lambda square against wavelength. So you can note this change. The lambda 3, which was called as lambda max in D0, the same wavelength is called as crossover point in first order, and now at the same wavelength you can see the maximum absorbance on the negative side. Okay, in the negative side. So now you can see lambda max in D0, crossover point in D1, and now this is maximum negative curvature in second order spectrum, that is D2 spectrum. And maximum positive curvature in D2 is this and this one. So these are the two positive curvatures in second order spectrum. So how many crossover points are there in second order derivative spectrum? You can see here first and second. These were the two crossover points in D2 spectrum. Now these two small maxima in D2 spectrum are called as satellite bands. Now you all also can try constructing the higher derivative spectra, that is third and fourth derivative spectrum. You can draw by taking any random example of the fundamental spectrum. Draw any random spectrum. Fundamental spectrum, note its peak width. Okay, and the rule of n plus I told you, that was the hint, that is if it is second order spectrum which you want to draw, then 2 plus 1, in that second order spectrum you should see 3 peaks. In third order derivative spectrum you should see 4 peaks. So that is the hint, how many number of peaks you have to draw. Now what about the height? Now height of the peak, that is the amplitude of peak, can be calculated by this formula. Now here this W, what is this W? You know, W is the peak width and N is the order of the derivative of the spectrum. So for example, you have to calculate the amplitude of this particular peak, and this peak width is suppose 2 units. Okay, so you will calculate it by 1/2, and for second order you want to find the amplitude of the second order spectrum. So this is 2 then, and this is how you will get the amplitude of the peak. Okay, so you can actually take the scale ruler and you can try constructing third and fourth derivative spectrum. So how you can do? You can just draw 2 overlapping peaks, one may be broad, one may be narrow, and see if this particular spectrum is converted into higher derivative. So each of this band will get broadened, 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 and they will get separated from each other. Now what are the advantages? An even order spectrum is of narrower spectral bandwidth than its fundamental spectrum. A derivative spectrum shows better resolution of overlapping bands than the fundamental spectrum and may permit the accurate determination of the lambda max of the individual bands. Now you can see this particular example. This we have done in our lab. my students, semester 8 students, they worked on this project. And see, initially this particular formulation had two drugs, paracetamol and caffeine into it. And you can see at lambda max of paracetamol, this caffeine is giving absorbance, and at the lambda max of caffeine, paracetamol is giving absorbance. So therefore, without separating two drugs from the solution, what we have done, we just converted this spectrum into higher derivative. This is the first derivative, and second derivative we did not do, we did only first derivative spectrum. So you can see each spectrum was then converted into the higher derivative, and here we have to choose such a wavelength where the another drug is giving zero absorbance. So this is also called as the zero crossing method for the analysis of binary mixture. So this is the biggest advantage, or rather we can say the application of the derivative spectroscopy, that is, this is called as zero crossing method. So zero crossing method, okay, for analysis of a binary mixture. Okay, selection of the wavelength is done for the further measurement of absorbance, and it is selected such that at the, see here, only this blue color is the absorbance where the other drug is giving zero absorbance. Now this is the wavelength chosen for measuring absorbance of this drug, because the other drug is, so that is called as zero crossing method. Even in small wavelength range, in presence of two or more overlap peaks, absorbance bands can be identified, and broad absorbance spectrum gives clear idea about the particular wavelength at that maximum spectrum. Background effects can be eliminated in derivative spectra. See, for example, there is some constant background effect. I mean to say, there is some constant absorbance in the background. So if we take a derivative of this particular spectrum where there is some constant absorption given by the solution in the background, so derivative of the of any constant is always zero. So in the first order derivative spectra, that background absorbance will be zero. Therefore this derivative spectra helps a lot for eliminating the background effects. So it's a very simple and cost effective method. It gives quick, easy and reproducible data, selectivity without separation of analyte. It improves sensitivity and specificity. It is faster than classical techniques and can be used where classical techniques are not applicable. And also it enhances the detectability of minor spectral features by eliminating interferences. Thank you for watching the video. Do subscribe for latest updates and click on bell icon. Do like and share, and do not forget to leave your comments. Thank you. Have a nice day.